carry your own weight on this, because actually we don't have any spare capacity to carry.
My name is Andrea Galotti. I did the undergraduate, the bachelor, from 2008 to 2012 here in Pollenzo. I met my husband here in Pollenzo. He started a year after me doing the undergraduate program. We knew, okay, we're two, so we can share the work and find other people and put the virus of Pollenzo into other people. And now we're in Karlsruhe. We have our restaurant Erasmus. We opened in May 2014. I think what you always carry with you when you studied in Pollenzo is the knowledge that you're not alone, that there's other people all over the world doing crazy things.
My name is Edith Salminen. I come from Finland and I did a master's in food culture and communication. I'm working at full agency. My position on paper is editorial assistant and a project administrator. We do everything from events to lectures to dinners and cleaning and logistics and everything. All the experiences that I've gained at UNISG, I use every day. I learned a sort of code of conduct, let's say, at UNISG, to be able to deal with all these situations.
I'm Pia Lambert. I'm 29 years old from Germany. I did the master course Italian Gastronomy and Tourism in Colorno, the last one. Yes, I'm working as a food buyer now for a German company that's called Manufaktum. Basically, I have the impression that I'm still on or directly at the university, because there are so many producers I've met during the university I'm working now with.
Hi everybody, I am Edoardo Moussanet. I live in Paris nowadays, but I'm Italian. I graduate in Gastronomic Sciences here in Pollenzo. I work as F&B director in Galeries Lafayette. I think that this university gives me the right qualities in order to do in the good way my job today.
My name is Cindy Johnson. I'm the Director of Human Resources for the Broadmoor Hotel in Colorado Springs, Colorado, USA. I think that's what I think is most important, is meeting students in person here in Italy versus over a Skype interview or anything, really making that connection and really hopefully establishing a long-term relationship with the school itself.
Hello, my name's Heather Anderson. Together with my husband Pete Ritchie, we run Whitmuir Organics. It's a working farm with a shop and a restaurant in Scotland. Well, we get very excited about the fact that we think food is becoming is much more political, that there's a new generation of people who are taking food really seriously and want to change the food system. And this is part of the epicenter of that movement. You know, so all the strands around the politics of food, the sustainability of food, the culture of food, the economics of food, it's all been discussed on this course. So this is where you've got to be, really. This is the heartbeat of the whole movement.
We're offering several opportunities. We have 6 and 12 month internships available for this year, as well as next year and beyond, in the culinary arts, in restaurants, in guest services, in front office, and in reservation sales. So what I really love is that students have a lot of different choices, but these students chose to come to speak to me about the Broadmoor. And I think they have a real interest in going to the United States, learning about luxury resorts, learning about how their passion for food and gastronomy could fit into the Broadmoor. So my first impressions are very positive. I think there's a lot of energy, a lot of enthusiasm and genuineness. So I think the interviews have gone extremely well. I've really been pleased.
Pete and I are quite old, and what we need are some really bright young people to come and do stuff for the website, work with Q codes, do marketing in a non-word laden way. You know, we're very good at writing text. What we need are people to do short films, photo montages, you know, creative interpretations of the story. It's really exciting to see young people interested in changing the food system. I wish we could take all of them.
I couldn't have been working as an editor. I couldn't have been meeting with producers and chefs without my knowledge that I gained here.
If you work with food in whichever direction and you have this knowledge, people are amazed and interested, and more you can tell, the better it is. So,
which advice to give to a Pollenzo student? But I think that the most important thing is not to consider this university as the other university. You have to live the Pollenzo adventure.
Be confused and don't know what you want to do, because that's when you really know what's gonna be good for you. So good luck.
Do the networking stuff and continue to keep in touch with all your classmates, and even with the producers you've met during the stage, they can teach you a lot, and just use it.
Never underestimate how important it is to stick to what you believe in.
Profits, profits and profits of this experience.
Bye bye, Pollenzo.
Okay, see you. Bye. À la prochaine.